Phelps, welcome to Vice. This is your new partner, Roy Earl. Take a seat. A special request was made to transfer you to add Vice. We need a man with your kind of starch on this desk, son. We have two dead Negroes found in an apartment this morning on Yucca Street. Number 6358, apartment 5.
We got better things to be doing than wasting our time on two dead junkies.
Did I ask your opinion, detective? Two men dead on U.S. Army issue morphine. That makes it an advice case. Beat it!
Yes, sir. You and the lieutenant have some history?
You could say that. We used to be partners. So, you're working with the big boys now, Cole.
I guess so, Roy. I thought homicide was the primo assignment.
That may be the case. I asked for you personally, Phelps. I had to pull a few strings to get you over to Advice. How does it feel?
The lieutenant seems to think I'm doing okay.
Okay? Don't get humble on me, Phelps. You're doing great. You're the department pinup boy. War hero and crime fighter. What a combination.
I can assure you I'm no war hero, detective.
I'm going to memorize your
name. Let's rouse some hop heads.
And throw my head away.
Nice car, Roy. Is it department issue?
No, it's my sled. You can't be seen slumming it in a Nash if you're in Vice, Cole. Meanwhile, we got needle freaks kissing it goodbye all over Central Avenue.
Any in the vicinity, officer needs assistance. 1825 North Highland Avenue.
Who in God's name would eat at that hovel?
People of color, Roy.
They really picked a prize shithole for our first date.
I swear, this town is going straight to hell.
I want to see.
It's up the stairs, detectives.
Excuse me, officer, I want to see.
Around the corner. Last door on the left.
Keep talking. Come on, Dunn. Say something intelligent.
Your show now.
What's going on over there?
Carruthers.
Phelps?
I've been reassigned to Advice.
What have we got?
Two stiffs, overdosed, been dead a couple of days.
Government issue morphine? We use the same syrettes in Okinawa.
Fucking Negro junkies can't take supply this pure.
You know these guys?
I know of them. The younger one's a two-bit horn player by the name of Cornell Tyree. The other one works in distribution. Started using a little too much of his own product and Jack D took exception. He wasn't born that ugly. His name's Lamont. Tyrone Lamont.
So who's supplying the drugs?
That's easy. Whoever knocked off the wharves in San Pedro. Jack Dragna, Mickey Cohen. Dope's been all upside down ever since Jimmy Utley started the long walk at Quentin.
You talk about it like it's a system.
It was a system. But those days are long gone.
We are supposed to uphold the law.
Yeah, and we do. But we can't change people. The truth is, everyone wants the license to get a little dirty now and then. Our job is to keep it manageable.
That's how you see it?
See it any other way, and you better forget about being a vice cop.
Can we get on with this? Today, preferably?
I Tyrone Lamont, not even 23 years old. A small chance in life is probably better than no chance.
You catch all the good ones, fellas.
These clowns lived on popcorn?
Must have been messy eaters. It's all over the floor. Black Caesar from the joint across the street. Took his jolt and drifted off. And I suppose his friend wasn't in any condition to notice that he had stopped breathing. Some kind of fruit, a bell, and wind. Strange doodle.
Just when I think I've seen it all.
Another special order from the Caesar. What's the correlation between love of the needle and love of the music?
You catch all the good ones, Phelps.
Street life have no idea how dangerous this stuff is. Bottom of the cup. No cooking or preparation. Must have been the easiest fix these two ever had.
Find anything interesting?
Another special order from the Caesar.
Never the same, are they?
One cigarette is enough to knock you out for combat trauma. Two of them will stop your heart. Say only the good die young. I hope it was true in your case.
Find anything interesting?
Who is JJ? And why do these two care about his taste in music? Looks like it was always gonna end this way.
All the good ones, Phelps.
A bit heavy. heavy for an empty cup. I think we're getting them fixed right over the counter in broad daylight.
The Emperor across the street appears to shift a lot of popcorn. Let's shake him down.
They've been dead at least a day. Let me get them back.
Right. Let's wrap this up before I actually have to work overtime instead of just claiming for it.
You're a true inspiration to us all, Roy.
Did you read about the woman who stabbed her husband and pushed him in front of the car? That's the cop reporter.
That broad got socks in.
Help you?
Detectives Phelps and Earl, LAPD. We're inquiring into the deaths.
Hand over the popcorn, numbskull, before we kick the door in. Get that son of a bitch. Cop, you fucking animals.
How about your ears? Ah! Ah! Not in the face.
What's your name?
Morgan.
Half an answer is no answer to me, asshole.
Fleetwood Morgan.
Keep an eye on him, Roy, while I take a look around.
Keep very still, Fleetwood. Don't give me an excuse to shoot you.
That's that cop. He's like a decent...
Everything here is going to be relevant.
Number slips might affect your tone, Fleetwood. It should be stamped on the reverse by the issuer.
Not much help.
might not be filling, but I'm sure it's satisfying. We're inquiring about the deaths of two men in an apartment across the street, Fleetwood. We want answers.
Of course. I'll do my best, mister.
You sold the drugs to Cornell Tyree and Tyrone Lamont.
Oh, I sell fried steaks and black eyed peas.
You're lying, Fleetwood. We know that you supplied them.
I don't know nothing about no drugs. All I do is my tan hair flipping burgers. Can you prove any different?
Flipping burgers and strapping jolts of morphine to the bottom of popcorn cups, Fleetwood. Now I want the truth. Who supplies the drugs?
Cat by the name of Armstrong Edwards. All right, brings the stuff around about once a day.
I know Armstrong. He's a two-bounce, strictly small time. Who's he working for, Fleetwood?
Jermaine Jones.
We have you for the hop and resisting arrest. Tell us about the numbers if you want our help.
Look, the numbers are the white man's tax on poor folk. All right, now what else you want to know?
We have an address on the slips. We're going to go down there now and rat you out, Fleetwood. Tell whoever it is that you rolled over and gave them up.
No. Look, I've been cooperative, okay? Now you gotta help me some.
Fleetwood, I'm gonna speak personally to the judge on your behalf.
A name, Fleetwood.
Well, he's a real slick dude. Wears a hat and swings a cane. Goes by the name of Merlin, all right? I ain't got a last name.
See you at the station, Fleetwood.
Wait, you're gonna help me, right?
Of course, kid. You helped us out. We always like to repay a favor. Can you see that Fleetwood gets a nice cell, Wallace? One with a window and a nice fresh pillow.
Operator, give me dispatch.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
Detective.
I need an address on a Jermaine Jones musical booking agency.
Just a moment, Detective. Jermaine Jones. The office is listed as 5528 Santa Monica Boulevard.
Thanks for your help.
That's that cop. Seemed like a decent guy.
He's only a writer.
So you know the way. You can drive.
Fine. Where are we headed? I heard you were in the blue room the other night. Shouldn't you have been at home? Tucked in bed with the wife and kids?
Where I go is your business.
It couldn't have had anything to do with a certain delightful but damaged German girl, could it?
I don't know what you're talking about, Roy.
Look at this place. I'm guessing not much talent comes out of this talent agency.
Hey! Who let you in?
Jermaine Jones.
Don't bother getting up. Your flunky Fleetwood Morgan just snitched you out.
I wasn't planning to. Now you think you could tell me who the hell you are?
LAPD. We'd like to take a look around.
The hell you will, motherfucker. You carrying a warrant?
No, do we need one? Search the place, Cole.
What do you think you're gonna find, policeman? Huh?
Scott Phantom. Fine radio. Shortwave, AM and FM. My father has a Scott.
You ain't allowed to do this. I got rights.
This thing is sounding a little muffled here, man.
Brennan, Wilt, get over here. Take these assholes apart.
You heard the boss.
Is this the best you got? Mugger dope for the eyeballs.
Clean them up quick, boys. I ain't got time for this.
Hey, Cole. Sit tight, asshole. Pretend you're at the parlor getting your nails done. Cole, you better search through that stuff in the radio before you brace our friend here. Still have those tears and those
rocks in my heart. How many starving musicians pay with perfect, clean 50s? I didn't stay, ran away,
wouldn't play. This must be how those two bums standing guard take their wages.
Your friend Fleetwood was also a betting man. Too much for felony possession. I'm thinking intent to supply. Might as well give up the fight. I know darn well he'll convince me that he's right again. When he sings that silent song, I just nothing significant. With that old devil called love, he'd follow me around. Nope. Build me up, tear me down, till I'd be so bewildered, I wouldn't know what to do. I hope none of this stuff is purloined, Mr. Jones.
I have a receipt for that thing. Somewhere.
Lamont and Tyree are dead. At a stretch, the DA could have you on felony murder for supplying stolen government
money. Tyrone and Cornell are dead.
They're on a slab downtown with the ME examining their last meal. Popcorn washed down with morphine.
Are you offering me a deal?
I have a pet judge who hates blacks. He'll give you 50 years for your two buddies. Another 30 for stealing from Uncle Sam. You'll be out by the time you're 110. Imagine the changes I see.
I get the message. How much is this gonna cost me?
Who supplies the morphine?
I don't know nothing about that.
So we make you for all of it. You're the fall guy from Mickey Cohen.
In case you haven't noticed, I'm a colored man. You see any Jew boys running around here? I collect my cut. Lenny the Fink controls the action.
Lenny who?
Lenny Finkelstein, Mickey's dipshit brother-in-law.
What is the link between the morphine and the numbers slips?
There is no link. You're wasting your time here.
You're lying to me, Jones. Tell me about Merlin.
Who? I don't know anyone named Merlin.
Fleetwood Morgan will testify that you and Merlin are expanding out of illegal gambling and into drugs.
Okay. So I buy from a cat goes by the name of Merlinati. Merlin runs the lottery for the Jew boy. The Fink has a new line in drugs. You squeal me out, I deny ever telling.
Tell us about Adi.
Adi's a gambler. Fronts points on football games, fights, the horses, numbers. Chicken crossing the road. Motherfucker will take the odds on anything. I'm a booking agent. Can't you see that I'm busy and I don't have time to be wasting with you clowns?
What, you're giving up and going home?
Get back here, Cole.
Ramez removals. They must have taken special care delivering this for you.
Seems like old times, dinner dates and flowers, just like old times, staying up for hours.
What's the score with Ramez removals?
I brought a radio from there. That's all.
So when we visit Rama's removals and tell them that we want a special bookcase or wardrobe to hide our dope in, they're going to be copacetic.
And when we tell them their good friend Jermaine sent us and said they could do a nice deal for the LAPD.
I could use an act like you two. There's Futzabin and Costello are on the slide. Hollywood could use another couple of deeply unfunny white bread humps like you.
Very good, Jermaine. You have character. Now cough it up.
Ramez is a good friend of Lenny the Fink. You getting the picture?
Take them all in.
We have a deal, right?
We're after the morphine. I'll speak to the DA on your behalf. You have my word.
I'm gonna get good and tight come Friday.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need an address for Ramez Removals. That's Ramez, R-A-M-E-Z.
Just checking. Ramez Removals, corner Sunset and Wilton. Owned by a Jose Victor Ramez.
Thanks, man.
Isn't he the cop they've been talking about on the radio? Want another commendation?
You can drive.
Do we know where we're going?
That was Hopgood. Who? Marlon Hopgood, your informer. He was my corroborating witness in the Bishop case.
Oh, right. Marlon. You're not still sore about that, are you? You made the case without him.
He was an accessory to the abuse of the girl, Roy.
As long as Hollywood exists, it's gonna be chewing up starry-eyed little girls. Marlon was small time. You caught the big fish. And look how much good it did your career.
LAPD, we're here to see Jose Ramez.
What's it about?
Routine inquiries, sir. Can you tell us where we could find him?
We missed him.
He was in the delivery truck, just went out.
God damn it. 11K calling KGPL.
Go ahead, 11K.
11K requesting assistance. In pursuit of narcotic suspects aboard a GM delivery truck. Commercial license, David Charles, 457.
Roger, 11K.
Hit him! Clear this asshole off the road!
What does this lunatic think he's doing?
We're not playing around here. Take this clown off the road.
Get in, here comes the cavalry.
Let's see how fast he runs on bare rims. Step on it, huh? Just give me a little closer.
Hit him. He's going left onto Hollywood. Get alongside him and take him out.
That's it, Cole. You did it. It's truck's history. Pull him out of there.
Put your hands where I can see them. Jose Ramez, you're being arrested on suspicion of supplying illegal drugs, resisting arrest, and for malicious damage to LAPD property.
Hey, hold your horses. I supply furniture, not drugs. And that thing back there? That was an accident. Some furniture came loose. That's all. Save it for the DA, Chico.
Keep an eye on him. We're gonna take a look around inside.
Where's he been delivering? And who's been delivering here? Any repeat business in the ledger, Cole?
Why is Ramez buying so much ice? Melanotti is buying a lot of furniture.
Thank you.
Couldn't you think anywhere else to meet, kid?
We like to choose our ground.
What is that supposed to mean? Huh?
It's something Wellington said at Waterloo. The guys who win normally choose where to fight.
We're gonna fight, kid? The two of you versus my boys here? I love the fight game. I went a few rounds myself. You and your friend, he looks tough, but I don't like your chances. Nah.
We don't have to fight, Mr. Cohen. We have you an infilate.
What the fuck is that? Some kind of stake?
It means my men are in cover, but that they can still shoot you.
If those were my orders, you would all be dead now.
Are you kidding me? This is a $200 coat. You got some balls.
Kelso.
I hope you didn't scratch the paint of my new Lincoln.
Mm-mm. These guys are getting out of the dope business, Mr. Cohen. You'll have no more problems from them. The morphine is going to disappear back into the sea.
Hang on. You're getting hasty. There's a lot of dough on offer here.
Thanks for the offer, Mr. Cohen, but we are going to have to politely decline. After today, the morphine is no more.
This isn't the way we normally do business.
I'm aware of that, Mr. Cohen.
Call me Mickey. Are you aware of the risk, huh?
I'm giving it to you straight, Mr. Cohen. There will be no more morphine. We made a mistake and would like to back out gracefully. If you come after us, we will be forced to come after you.
You've been polite up till now, so don't stop making threats.
I don't make threats, Mr. Cohen. I'd like to thank you for your time.
Is that guy your idea, Muscle Kid?
There's something you should know about Jack, Mr. Cohen. He killed 6 Japs hand-to-hand with just a bayonet and a K-bar knife. His outfit, the 6 Marines, killed over 100,000 Japs in 3 months in Okinawa, and he was in the thick of it.
Those Japs are little guys, right?
Yes, Mr. Cohen. About your size.
What's with the puddle? Where's that trail of water coming from, Cole? There must be a way through the back. Welcome to Furniture Village, where taste comes to die. What a pile of junk. My mother would be in heaven. I bet this is the kind of crap you love, Cole. 20 years out of fashion. Smells of old people in here. This is useless. I can't see a damn thing. You need to get up onto the floor above. Thank you. Get down here. There's a cold room in the back. I think we know where the water's coming from. You're gonna want to see this.
There's something frozen inside.
Well, I'll be damned.
This must be how they transport the morphine.
PD, leave it right there. Everyone out of the vehicle and put your hands up.
There's something in the ice.
He's making a run for it. Let him have it.
Give me some goddamn cover.
Take them all to Hollywood Station. Have the ME and tech services go over this place.
Where will you be?
Hunting polar bear.
You drive. I need to go over the case notes.
All right, where to?
Factory is closed. Has been for years. Not much call for ice anymore with all those newfangled refrigerators.
Save it for someone who wants to hear it. How many janitors carry a gat?
That's one way of announcing we're here.
Give it up, Finkelstein. Your brother-in-law will get you a good lawyer.
My brother-in-law hates my guts. Come and get me if you want some daylight for that suit of yours.
Answer me, goddammit. Construction cannot leave this building alive. Eyes open. Surround.
Throw out the guns.
Everything's fake here.
What the hell is the matter? Can someone keep this carry back over already?
You're fucking. I'm wide open here. I'm running out of friends or something here anytime soon. Understand? Oh. Give me some space here. Give me some goddamn cover.
Let's see if I can't put one right between your eyes.
Stay down.
I'm wide open here.
Clear me some space here. Stay in cover. Keep moving!
dead, Finkelstein. Leave the weapon and put your hands up now.
Put my hands up? Sure. Then what? Cop to peddling the dope? Cut a deal? Ship me off to the queue? As soon as I get locked up, some old friend puts an ice pick above my ear? No thanks.
Only one other way out, shitheel. Let's have a look around. Now that we finally got some peace and quiet. I think I've had enough ice for one day. Until the scotch I pour myself as soon as we get out of here. This stuff has got to be worth at least $100,000.
So Finkelstein robbed the ship?
My guess is Lenny took it off their hands. This is big. This is gonna make the papers, Phelps. As senior investigator, I'll do the talking.
Well, well. Who would have thought that Roy Earle's hand-picked new partner would have turned out to be such a great case man? This is a good result, Phelps. As far as we can tell, Lenny the Fink was moving the morphine across the city and as far north as Frisco. This makes the feds very happy, and it makes Mickey Cohen look bad. I won't lie to you, kid. I like the headlines. I like them a lot. You keep this squad in the papers, and we'll get along just fine.